Hi, this is CADCAM Lessons channel, and this is another part of the FreeCAD From Scratch tutorial, in which I show the basics of creating 3D models in this system. Earlier we discussed the basic issues related to creating a sketch and creating a solid based on a 2D sketch, and in this video we will return to creating a sketch and discuss issues related to constraints. As I mentioned earlier, constraints are something that defines the relationships between geometries or between geometry and the origin of the coordinate system, and constraints make it very easy to create a 2D sketch. A certain type of constraints are dimensions, because dimensions also define relations between geometries or between geometry and the origin of coordinate system. However, when it comes to dimensions, dimensions define specific distance between selected elements, and when it comes to such typical constraints, constraints define relations, and such a relation can be, for example, a symmetry constraint, which will determine that two selected geometries are to lie symmetrically relative to some axis, and then we will not really be interested in the dimension value, because these geometries will always be symmetrical relative to the selected axis if we simply add such relation. And we will temporarily open another project, and as I mentioned, in FreeCAD we can have several projects open, and let's add a new project. Just click this icon, and here, as you can see, a new project has appeared, and in this place we have a tab with a new project, and we have a new project in the operations tree. Let's create a sketch, select sketch plane, and here I will briefly talk about several selected constraints, but first make sure that in this place, after expanding this menu, you have the auto constraints and auto remove redundancy selected. It is quite important to have these options selected, because if these options are not enabled, various types of errors may appear. For example, the sketch may change color to orange, and something like this confuses novice users of FreeCAD and simply causes unnecessary frustration. And in a moment I will show you what it is all about, and at the beginning I will create a rectangle, and let's draw any rectangle, for example like this. And now I would like this rectangle to be placed symmetrically relative to the y-axis. That is simply so that there is the same amount of the rectangle on the left and on the right side of the y-axis. And we can do this easily. Just select two opposite vertices of this rectangle lying on the same line, then select the line that is to be the axis of symmetry. In this case, select y-axis and select the symmetry constraint. And now if I grab the vertex of the rectangle and change its position, both on the left side of the y-axis and on the right side of the y-axis, the dimension is the same. Simply, this rectangle in this axis is symmetrically placed relative to y-axis. We can do the same when it comes to symmetry relative to the x-axis. Simply select these two vertices, then select the x-axis and select the symmetry constraint. And now if I grab the vertex of the rectangle, this rectangle is symmetrical relative to both the y-axis and the x-axis. And the symmetry constraint has defined such a relationship here that regardless of the dimensions of this rectangle, it has to be symmetrically placed relative to the axis of the coordinate system. Now I will press Ctrl plus Z, and when it comes to FreeCAD, we can also add constraints relative to a point. I pressed Ctrl plus Z so as to remove both symmetry constraints. And now when it comes to the symmetry constraint, what we did is as if adding two symmetry constraints, one relative to y-axis, the other relative to the x-axis, we can do with one constraint. We can add a constraint relative to a point. Now if I select this vertex of the rectangle and this vertex of the rectangle and then the origin of the coordinate system, and if I select the symmetry constraint, now this rectangle is symmetrical relative to both axes of the coordinate system. That is what we did earlier with two constraints. Here we have solved with one constraint. Now I will delete this geometry, select this geometry, press delete, and now I will uncheck the option to auto remove redundancy, and I draw a rectangle. And now I will add a symmetry constraint relative to the y-axis. And the error that I mentioned appears. We have a redundant constraints here, and this is what I mentioned at the beginning, that sometimes among novice users these types of errors appear, and very often it is related to the fact that this option is not enabled. It is about the fact that by simply adding subsequent constraints, those that are unnecessary will be automatically deleted. And in this case, in the case of this particular geometry, the unnecessary constraint is the constraint that specifies that this line is horizontal, and this constraint was added automatically when drawing the rectangle. And after adding a symmetry constraint, this constraint is an unnecessary because the symmetry constraint between these two points automatically determines that this line is a horizontal line. Now if I click here, this constraint will be highlighted and we can delete this constraint. We can press delete and this constraint will be deleted and the rectangle will be placed symmetrically relative to the y-axis. And here I just wanted to show you that you should pay attention to whether you have these two options selected, so as to avoid this type of error. Okay, I select this geometry, and this was a short introduction to constraints. Let's select this option, and here I will come back for a moment to the rectangle. Okay. I place this rectangle symmetrically relative to the origin of the coordinate system. Okay, and I will add dimensions. Here 70 and here 50. Okay, and note that this rectangle is symmetrically placed relative to the origin of the coordinate system. And now when I change this dimension, for example, to 150, okay, the rectangle has been enlarged, but the symmetry constraint is preserved, and we simply have the same part of the rectangle on the left and on the right side, and in many cases adding constraints can be better solution than adding dimensions. Now, for example, I will create two circles. And now I would like these circles to be placed symmetrically relative to the y-axis. Pay attention to the fact that these circles lie in this way. They don't lie at the same height. I select these two points and y-axis and select the symmetry constraint. And now automatically these circles were aligned. They lie on one line because this is what the symmetry constraint is responsible for, so that these geometries lie at the same distance from the y-axis. And now when I change the position of one circle, the position of the second circle also changes. And the next constraint that I would like to show you is the equality constraint. First, I will dimension one circle. I will add a diameter of 10 millimeters here. And now I would like these circles to have the same diameter. And we could do it in such a way that we simply add another dimension. Okay, we select the circle, we enter the diameter, and we have the same circles. However, if I would like to make some changes, it turns out that these circles are to have a diameter not 10 millimeters, but for example 15 millimeters, then I have to edit each of these circles. I need to change its diameter. Okay. If there are several geometries, then we can do it this way. We can manually change the dimensions of these geometries. But if there were, for example, more geometries, then changing the diameter of each of the geometry would be time consuming. I will remove this dimension. I select all the circles. I simply point with the left mouse button at these circles and select the equality constraint. And pay attention to what will happen. All the circles now have the same diameter, and if I change the diameter of one circle, the diameters of the other circles will be adjusted. And this is a huge advantage of constraints, because here we have added relations of these circles, and this relation determines that all the circles have the same diameter, and then it is enough that we change the diameter of one circle, and the diameters of the other circles will also be changed. And this is such a very simple example that shows the advantage of using constraints. Now I select these circles, I press delete to remove them. And another useful constraint can be a constraint defining that to place a point on a line. And to do this, select this point and select the line and select constraint point onto object. And now in this case the center of the circle has been connected with the x-axis, and the only change in position geometry that I can do at this point is that I can move these circles along the x-axis. I can't move this circle up or down. I can move these circles along the x-axis only. And here, as you can see, we have one more degree of freedom. These geometries are not fully constrained, and we will add the dimension of the distance of the center of the circle from the edge of the rectangle. Select the center of the circle, select this point, and here at, for example, 25 millimeters, and this circle will always be offset by 25 millimeters regardless of what this dimension is. If I enter here, for example, 200 millimeters, then this circle will always be offset by 25 millimeters from the edge of the rectangle. And this results from the fact that here we have added a constant distance of the center of the circle from this edge of the rectangle. And when it comes to this circle, we have a symmetry constraint here, and this circle behaves the same as this circle. We can do it in another way. We can add the distance between the centers of the circles. Just select these two points and select this dimension and enter here 100 millimeters. Okay, and now regardless of what the dimension here is, these circles will be placed symmetrically about the y-axis, and the distance between the centers of the circles will be 100 millimeters. And okay, that's where we will end this example. I just wanted to start the topic of constraints here and show that there is something like that, and that we can add relations between geometry not only using dimensions, but also using constraints. For now, let's close this sketch, close this project without saving. And in the next lesson, we will come back to this example and we will create more geometry here, and we will use information from this part of the tutorial. And that's all for today. Thanks for watching, and if you don't want to miss the next parts of the tutorial, please subscribe to this channel.